Was ist denn?
What's up, pussy boy? Huh? You got something to say? Are you the fucking Brit? Fucking Brit traitor? Huh? Get on your knees! Get on your fucking knees! I'm not doing it for you!
People have been held there for 4 years now almost. What possible intelligence value could they be giving after all of this time, even if there was any to begin with? So I would say categorically, not only should the United States close the place down, I think people should be repatriated. Those people who have committed crimes should be charged. Those people who have not should be released and should be compensated, if it's possible to compensate people for the time and for the physical and mental torture that they've had to suffer all of this time.
Oh yes, it has become a cancer in our mind, and we can never forget this, what happened to us. And it is just torturing us mentally right now when I just think about Guantanamo, I think about Kandahar, I think about Bagram, I think about the cells of ISI, the way I cannot forget the night we were arrested, the way we left our children crying. Without reason, we haven't been criminal. We haven't done anything wrong. We have been journalists. We have been scholars. We have been intellectuals here. We have been reporters and editors. You can see the library here.
Nou, ik constateer dat het echt een anomalie is in de internationale rechtsorde. Het had er niet moeten zijn, het had er niet mogen komen en het moet nu weg. Het systeem op zich mensen onwettig daar naartoe brengen, ook nog met geheime vluchten, dat lijkt natuurlijk helemaal nergens op. Er is nog niemand berecht in die 5 jaar door een Amerikaanse rechter, dus het werkt ook nog niet eens. En dan denk ik, ja, waarom zou je dan, ja, wat wil je er überhaupt mee? Zorg gewoon dat je mensen die je ergens van verdenkt, dat je die beschuldigt, dat je die een goede, dat je die gewoon duidelijk beschuldigt. We verdenken je hiervan, dat je bewijzen verzamelt en dat je vervolgens zorgt met een goede advocaat en een goede aanklager dat er een fair proces plaatsvindt.
When they handed out Qurans to us in Bagram, I remember seeing the Americans passing them through the Sally ports and throwing them to the ground, which some people might think, well, it's just a book. But if you believe as a Muslim does, a Muslim believes that this is the unadulterated, revealed word and speech of God. And it is the most sacred thing that any Muslim would have in his house. To see them do that, for me personally, brought about a sense of complete desperation that I can't do anything about this. And then for the other Afghans and various Arab prisoners, it was intolerable.
This is the whole block you can see, you know. This was the whole block. And there were two rows. Each row there were 24 cells. 24 cells. And then there was another row of 24 cells, you can see. In each cell was 180 centimeter, okay? 180 centimeter, and the length and the width and the height was 180 centimeter. And it was the place where we had to sleep, where we had to offer our prayers, where we had to go to the bath. And that was the whole thing we had in our life.
Is there ground for criticism? There's always ground for criticism of a government. And in a democracy, we expect and want the people to be aware of what's going on and to criticize their government when they see fault. At the same time, I feel that that the United States government has been extremely responsive to the concerns raised by the public, by its own citizens, and has dealt with the issues as they've arisen.
Thank you.
United Nations Convention Against Torture includes in Article 1 a definition of torture, and that comprises not only physical torture, but also intentional serious mental suffering inflicted on a person intentionally for a certain purpose, such as obtaining information or a confession, or punishing the person or somebody else. So it can constitute torture of a person or a family member if intentional mental suffering is caused for those purposes.
Guards had put barbed wire at the back of the back of the cages or the cells where we'd use that area's latrine. This apparently detainee had managed to push the barbed wire through and crawl out and run out, completely confused as to whether he's going left or right or where he was going to go in his orange suit. So the guards caught him and they beat him literally to death, after which they dragged him in front of all of the cells that were there. And that's when I saw his body.
Als je zegt, we willen dat de wereld democratisch functioneert volgens rechtsnormen, dan is Guantanamo is daar volstrekt strijdig mee. Met alles wat in een democratisch en door het recht genormeerd systeem mogelijk zou moeten zijn. Het kan gewoon niet. Internationaal recht verbiedt het. Het is onwettig. Dus ja, dat moet je dan gewoon niet doen.
Nog altijd worden ongeveer 400 mensen gevangen gehouden op Guantanamo Bay. Ondertussen is het beruchte Camp X-Ray gesloten en vervangen door Camp Delta. Vorige maand drong mensenrechtenorganisatie Amnesty International aan op de sluiting van het kamp in Guantanamo Bay. Amnesty herinnerde eraan dat de gevangenis nog steeds in strijd is met de conventies van Genève. Tot nu toe wil Amerika daar niks van weten.